St. Sozin Feast of Raising of the Cross, and a miracle we saw during the Holy Liturgy. We celebrated this twice, one September 14th and one on the 27th of September. And this event took place on the 14th. It was the first day of school for children in Greece. And the children that help, the altar boys that help, were not able to attend the Holy Liturgy, even though they wanted to. So this is what we do every year. Annually, we celebrate the finding of the cross of Christ's crucifixion. It was found by the mother of the Emperor Constantine. Saint Constantine and his mother, Saint Helen, did a lot for finding the areas of the holy sites in the Holy Land. And we know that Emperor Constantine of the Roman Empire was the first to allow Christians to freely practice their religion without persecution and prejudice. And he even set up the city of Constantinople in Byzantium, which is today called Istanbul, meaning Istanbul, Istinboli, meaning to the city being Constantinople. And he set up and built palaces there and asked the elite of the Roman Empire to come and live there. And basically, that was the second Rome. It was Constantinople. But anyway, going back to what happened, we celebrate this every year. There's a lot of feasts taking place in the month of September. It's the month of Hebrew Rosh Hashanah, and basically the whole month of September has a lot of beautiful celebrations. We have the birth of our Virgin Mary on September 8th. We have the Feast of St. Sozin on September 7th. We have the celebration of the raising of the Holy Cross September 14th with the new calendar and 27th with the old calendar. Now I want to tell you what happened during the beginning of the Holy Liturgy, well, beginning towards the middle. As I told you, the altar boys were at school, and they were very sad not to be able to come to the Holy Liturgy. But at one point, I saw one of the, this is what they were wearing, the golden vestments at that time. And I saw him standing at the left door, the northern door, the door of St. Michael. He was standing there looking at all the people. I mean, I wasn't sleeping. My eyes were, I was awake. And I saw one of the little altar boys that said he wanted to be there, but he couldn't because they had to go to begin school, and they had to be there because they would be given their books, would be given directions how to wear their masks, how to social distance from other children, etc. So it was important for them to be there, even though he wanted to skip it. But anyway, and I saw him standing there and looking and gazing at all the people in the church. What all the people, you know, with our social distancing, there's only about 13, 14 people allowed, and the rest are outside in the front garden of the church. Our weather is still beautiful, so it's just beautiful to be sitting. We have chairs out there, and it's like an open-air open-air church. It reminds us of what the churches were in the beginning of the early Christian era, right? And this is the basil plants. We give little pieces of basil plants to people at the end of the Holy Liturgy. But he was standing there. I was saying, what is he doing there? Did he miss school? He finally came to the Holy Liturgy. And then I didn't see him again. At the end, I asked his grandmother, who lives there, I said, your grandson was here. She said, no, he wasn't. I said, what do you mean? I saw him standing at the northern door of the St. Michael. He said, no, he wasn't here. He's at school. And later after that, I went into the reading room and by chance opened up the Holy Bible about this. As we know, our church tells us, open up the Holy Bible and our Lord will give you his word to answer you. And the passage that fell was, in the New Testament, the event where St. Peter was in prison and an angel appeared to him and released him. And then he went to find the disciples and a woman. He said, it's me, open the door. And the woman, disciple said, it's Peter's voice outside. It must be his angel, meaning his guardian angel. And then Peter heard her and said, no, it's not my angel, it's me. So anyway, there are things that the early Christians knew about how the angels work and help us. And they even look like us and sound like us. But then I told this happening to the priest, Father Vasily here, who is offering incense to Christ. We do a lot of offering of incense to God with the holy censer. It smells beautiful and reminds us of that's the way God smells. That's the word, the way the word of God smells beautiful, as the Apostle Paul tells us in the New Testament. He says, it's probably the angel of our church that took the form of the little altar boy. I won't say his name. And I said, oh, really? I said, that makes sense, because when I opened up the Holy Bible by chance, it gave us a passage about the angel, the woman disciple, talking about the angel of St. Peter appearing in his place with his voice. So this is what happened, a very blessed thing. Now, there are a lot of spiritual gifts that God gives us in this church, because this is a church of a very poor shanty town with poverty and pain and want. And God is rich in poor churches. He gives a lot of graces and spiritual experiences. And this is just one of them. And I did tell the little boy about this, and the cantor said, you're so blessed that the angel of our church took on your appearance. It's an amazing experience. But, you know, people say, why should I go to church? The more you go to church, the more God gives you such experiences. And here we have some of the parts of the Holy Liturgy of the raising of the Holy Cross of Christ. God bless you and mark you as his, and make you saints in your areas. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. Oh, Thank you. Oh.
If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events, events not covered by mainstream media, and not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, in Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.